Cheers, everyone. My name is Dario, and welcome to my Permadeath Survival Challenge in Space Engineers. And this is the new look of Luna. I hope you like it. In the end, I changed the skin to give it a color similar to the other vessels that we have. Here the shuttle and the Truckasaurus. So instead of the white or grayish color that I had, I changed it to this one. I added some wings here. I don't think it's gonna do much, but just, you know, for the looks. These are actually, let me see, lightning rod. So with the storms, like you would have probably just saw, every night it seems that we have a storm here. Not with lightning, luckily, but with low, you can see in my helmet here on the left side of the screen, low O2. I don't know if I open it. I can breathe. Today I can breathe. Anyway, besides the colors and adding these parts off camera, I also did a few things. Well, I started loading the with some ingots and things to go. I'm not gonna take any ore. These guys are really annoying. The hitbox is very, very hard. I decided with the landing gears that I'm gonna leave them as they are, because we can always land like this. And what I've done is separate on the toolbar these two, the rear, are in one button, and this one are separated. So we can use this to dock, and then you can go up the ramp. I think it's pretty cool. I really like this ramp. I don't know if when we get to the alien planet, the spiders, I don't know if they can get up, actually. The wolves, they don't come up. This has been open for quite a while and they didn't come up. See, the closest they get is down there, but they don't try. I don't know about the spiders though, so we have to see. This is one of the reasons that I want to keep like this, because I can close the ramp, for example, and we can just land in this way. We have some separation, hopefully enough that the spiders don't spawn inside, and then we can do the mining for the what's it called, the uranium, etc. What? This is freezing again. When these vessels spawn in, it freezes everything. Okay, what else did I do? Well, I added these turrets on the sides. I need to load them, actually. Did I load them? Nope. Need to load them. And the turret, I just put a little armor around, not much. It doesn't look very nice. I'm not really good at designing good looking things. I hope it works. I didn't have the chance because we didn't get any enemies coming around, luckily. You know, this vessel is never gonna be for fighting. We're gonna have to flee as soon as we see anything. We're gonna try to go up, and the reverse mode is on, so I'm gonna use the jump drives and try to get to Mars as soon as possible. So, and here I want to place when we have the platinum a shield. So that would be the head. Let me see the shield. See the shield. Oh, I already have one in this toolbar. We'll put it there. And it will be like a Mazinger Z or Robocop. Yeah, will be very cool. But now we can't. We will need a lot of gold also. So let me show you. Also, I did modify this. If you remember, the last episode we had Ion Thruster there, like we have here, right? This is the original vanilla Ion Thruster. Later I will change this to the sci-fi. I think it will look cooler. But here, because this so it was so tall, like up to here, in the middle, I changed it for this Iron Hospital mod, this thrust that doesn't occupy just a block. Of course, we don't have the thruster components, so we can't use it. It only uses 5 thruster components instead of, I think it's 80. But the con that it has, this one is 80 thruster components, so you need less platinum. But on the other hand, it uses a lot more power than the originals. I already set up the alarm. That's the sound block. The sensor is below, so it is already set. So when we have nasties around, it will beep beep beep, give us the sound. Here I changed also. You can see. So we have one more space that actually we can't use because we will get burned. Maybe we can put a catwalk in there and it won't get burned. We can try that. Do I have... yes, there it is. The one without the... this one. Yeah, that I don't think it will get burned. And we cover the that port that we're not gonna use. What we don't have? We don't have interior plates. Where is the? I went off camera also with the shuttle. I went over there to get some iron. I want this. I want this for the... for the turrets. Now will we finish? No? Did I turn off the build and repair? Why don't you go? It's in fly mode. Why is not working? Turn it off. Turn it on. Yes, we're not gonna do thruster components now. Why don't you do? I forget it. You know what? I'm gonna turn it off because I need to transfer some things. Give me the give me plate. Oh, I have a lot already. I'm not gonna take components in this vessel because it weighs a ton. There it is. So what I'm gonna do is just take a... that's another wolfie coming. Ingots. Because the ingots, you see, is almost no weight. And the refinery is working in some. Oh, it finished already. Well, we have 227. Well, a lot of iron now. See, but the weight is not as much. And I will leave the ore working with the Truckasaurus. Whenever we come back, we will have. Is refining iron, magnesium. Here the ore. See, I already left it to do a little bit of each. And we still have a boatload of gold here still. So I took almost all the ingots, actually. But it weighs way less. So if we need... the only thing is that if we need to repair, we get hit or something gets broken, I will need to build the components on the fly. But the Beetle Repairs tells you, ah, it's lacking this and that. You just produce it, it gets used, and you avoid the extra weight. That actually, I haven't tried it yet, and I don't know if we can get to space. I hope we can get to space with the vessel without a problem. We don't weigh that much, actually. Let me go. Hey. 773817. Yeah, it's not that much. If you compare it with the shuttle, for example, well, the shuttle now is there's a lot of iron, a little bit. So this one is almost 500,000. Look how small it is, and look at Luna. So I think we are gonna be fine to get to space. I will need a little. Oh, another thing that I did is map. You see here we have the toolbar, right? Everything is mapped now. As you can see, the landing gears, I have separated the both of them. Then here, this is the antenna. Put a plane antenna. Now I show you because it looks quite cool. I have a one jump drive is escape, so it's set to, I think it's 100 kilometers. If I see trouble, fly away, and it's set to recharge automatically. And then we have the exploration that it already gives us 2000 kilometers, I think. Jump, exploration, a maximum distance 4000, because it would use both of them, I guess. I don't believe it will, because I separated them. I think it's gonna be 2000. See, the escape I have set it to 2%, 100 kilometers, and this one I'm gonna put it to 50% actually, and go 2000 kilometers at a time. I don't want to use both. So if you see here, this is jump. If I see trouble, boom, just press there and fly away. And then the exploration, also jump, and the recharge on off. I can choose when to recharge the jump drive. That takes a lot of energy, and right now, because we don't have uranium, so here on the right hand side you can see it give us 1 day of power. When we start flying, the atmospheric thrusters take a lot of energy actually. With the hydrogen, once we are in space, just with the hydrogen, they use very little power. Now the tanks are full. So hydrogen tank is full, the oxygen tank is full. I would like to take a little ice. This ice we are getting from the moisture evaporators that actually I didn't map those. We'll have to turn them off. Once we get out of the atmosphere, we're not gonna get any ice from it. So actually, I should actually map that. We have the production, one number 3, and I'm gonna do this. Let me go here, moisture. Evaporators. Luna. Okay. I'm gonna put them in here as well. On off, so we can turn it off. Okay, and besides that, I think we are ready. We can try. Ah, you can see I placed another turret on the bottom here at the back. So we have one up, one down. And I hope you like it. Now it has changed a lot from the original, adding the wings. But I think it has a vibe with these colors, you know, with the Saturn on the left, the Truckasaurus. Hope you like it. And here, oh, the ATM I think you already saw. Actually, I'm gonna put the. I did get 925 credits. From deposit. I can choose. I have to do like this. 925 deposit. Okay. I did go for what's it called? One of the drop signals, unknown signals. It was like 500 meters from here, so I just went and picked it and picked everything that was there. This hey doggy, I hear you. I can't see you, but I hear you. Here I also mapped everything exactly the same, so I'm gonna add the moisture evaporators like we did upstairs, so we are exactly the same. Now what I'm gonna do is get some ice, and to do that I already turned off that build and repair. This one is on, if I remember correctly. This one is on. Okay, so I'm gonna come here. This is how we transfer the goodies with connectors. I need to turn the build and repair off so we don't pick up this assembly. We can turn off. And now, okay, let me place some ice in the connector. Oh, it already has 100 kilos, it would be enough. Now, this was conveyor sorter, I don't need because everything is here. This is toggle block on off. I didn't. Which toolbar is this? 3. Connector, I'm gonna put here, throw out, on off. Hey? Yeah, throw out, on off. Okay, so we turn on the connector, and there goes the ice, and the Luna build and repair should pick it up. And since the sorter is turned off, we are not picking up anything else from our inventory. Just the load is already finished. Okay, turn it off. The throwout off. We are set. We leave here Benson and Hedges, crew members on Earth. Good luck, guys. I hope you don't get attacked while we are away. And I didn't give a name to our guys in here, actually. Let's close the ramp. Hey, Benson and Hedges too. I hear more doggies. Okay, we are still. No, the refinery, I hear the sound, but it's not doing anything. Now let me check the ice. Oh, it more or less got even. Well, we don't have much ice, actually. That was the 100 kilos. Because in space, we won't be able to find any ice. Unless we get to the moon or to another planet. The asteroids won't have any ice with the scarce resources mod. I think that it weighs a lot, the ice. And I think we should be alright with the... You know, the tanks are full. I think we would be alright. You know, we just use the... What's it called? The jump drive. And the cruising, you know. Ah, let me put the ammo in here. I was going to forget already. 50 for you. We have to make more. This is the antenna from the Takeshi's plane parts mod. Oh, it's on the other side. And another 50 for you. So that's what we have. We have four small turrets as designators for the for this one, and the two large turrets on the back. What I was thinking is that later on, but now we don't have uranium or platinum. But later on, maybe we can take this out and put a missile launcher. Probably have to take out this, and we can shoot. But anyway, this is not gonna be a a fighting vessel anyway. So, what I could put here is a camera actually. Now that I think about it. Oh, now that I see this hinge, I didn't have time to. I can't see anything. Where are you? Oh, there it is. You know what? I think I won't be able to see anything with this in front. whoops. Yep. Well, we can see something. We can move the ship from the cockpit. We can move the ship around and avoid the thing. Better than nothing, right? So if we take this off, I don't know where we could put it here. Maybe another catwalk. Anyway, those are small details and we need to start moving on. I hope this is useful. The programmable block says that it's working. These are small steel catwalks. This is from Iron Hospital mod. This small catwalks there. See, they're very thin. At night it looks better. Huh? Still not very pretty, but anyway, that's what we have for now. Okay, so I don't know if this is gonna work actually. You know what? Let me just make sure we have here the. I'm gonna turn off the antenna to avoid any. Turn off the lights. And I'm gonna make a GPS. Do I have already the commission? Ah, the commission ship. On. Is it on? Turn it on. Okay, now. Yeah, it's here. So I have the GPS marker for when we come back. Okay, we don't need it right now. I just wanted to make sure that we had it. I don't need this now either. Okay. Give me another piece of meat. Wait, where are you? The hitbox is so small. Let me close the helmet, because once we are up there we won't have any oxygen except in this cockpit. So let's see. I don't know if this works. I haven't tried it, so I'm gonna make a save actually. I don't have the autosave enabled, because it takes a lot of every time it saves, freezes everything, takes a lot of resources to record everything, and every 5 minutes is a little pain. So I have to do it manually. I'm gonna turn off the, even though it's a very small radius, I'm gonna turn it off, you know, because of Reavers. And let's see. Here we go, guys. I have food, I have water. I think we are set. Let's get ready. All the engines up. Actually, the booster I'm gonna turn it off right now until we get up. I'm just gonna go up around 5,000 meters or so. There is the atmospheric, what it can give you. Maybe I can turn off the hydro also for now. I would prefer to do this during the day because we get some. Actually, I'm gonna do it. Sorry, it's just 1 minute. Turn everything off. Let's go to sleep. So I have the sleep mode enabled. So we just go to sleep. Here the with these colors, everything looks like a Tron. Have you seen the movie, the Tron? And now we're sleeping. There's the sunshine. Okay. Good morning, everyone. Beautiful morning. We didn't have a storm this night. I think it's the first time in so long. In the cockpit, and now we go. 6 and 8. Okay. Yeah. Unlock, and there we go. And in gears, turn off dampeners. We're not getting much speed. Now we get more speed with the hydro. Here we go. Still not much, huh? And it's going down the speed. Let me turn on the booster and let's start pointing up. now. We are still cruising. I can turn everything off. We're still cruising, going up. But where I'm gonna go is towards this. Now, I think it's less than 3,000 kilometers. The planet, right? So it's already set. This jump drive, we set it to 2,000 kilometers. So I'm just gonna jump. What? Cannot be used into natural gas. Oh, so we are less than 2,000 kilometers? Okay then. Let's say 1,500. Operational jump drive, this is a seat crew on board, 101, flying jump, boom, 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 100%, let's go. Bye. Now, I want to go to the pole, so we have some ice. And we are still moving because we're moving up, upwards, as the original push that we had. But even correctly, you see, we are 99.9 meters per second, which is good. So if any rivers spawn, we're moving fast. Now I want to go like over there. Now let me see. Could we still jump? Yeah, this one can jump 2,000. Let's do 400 kilometers. And go around there to the pole. It's not charged. Okay. Charge. Number 9. And let's get some sunshine. You are my sunshine. My only sunshine. Yeah, see, it's the one on the left. That is in yellow now. And we have 1 hour power right now. And how long do you need to charge? 5 minutes, no problem. Six, four, three, one, we are ready, both green. Okay, so now we want to go over there. On top of the gravity well, it will tell us. I'm just gonna do like 200 kilometers. Let's jump. No. Upwards the nose. Okay, I hope we don't go too far away. I hope we don't pass the planet. 2, 1. Where are we? Oh yeah, right on top. Excellent. Okay, let's turn on... and come to a stop. Which way is the... Okay, there. And the tank is full. 99.8. How are we doing on ice? We didn't use anything, huh? Just a, look at this, just a little ice. Actually, let me turn off the auto HD generators and see how much. We still have some ice when we land. We need to. Well, the oxygen tank is full, but if I need to make food or whatever, so we have a little before we collect. Okay, we're stationary now. Let's go to the. Let's go down. Missile post. MK1. I don't want to see you right now. I want to try to get to the edge of this. Turn off this. Okay, the Atmos. I'm not doing much right now. I'm gonna try to get to the edge of the ice and the terrain. We have a better chance. We were closer on this side than the other, so I just came here. It's gonna get dark anyway. As you see, we're dropping, but we're not dropping very fast. I turn off the hydrogen. When we turn off this, we can still glide with the wings. We're not going down that fast. Now we have no lift thrusters at all whatsoever. Okay, I think I wanna go this way. See, there's a depression there on the right. Yeah, I'm gonna go this way. 1000 meters. And let's see if we are lucky. Turn on the lifter atmospheric. We don't go down. Let's see if we are lucky and we find platinum fast. Where is the? Oh, I didn't map the ore detector. Do I have another detector now that I think about it? Okay, now we are slowing down. I don't know if we have another detector. Yeah, we should have, because the original vessel. Yeah, we do. It's right there. Oh, it scared me for a moment. Close this. The turrets are on, I just didn't allow them to do the idle movement. I don't think this is gonna be very flat. Maybe we are better on top of this hill for the sun also. And anyway, until we build another Truckasaurus. Oh, this is like a crater. We're gonna be quite high. No. Come. We're gonna have to go search for the ore with this vessel. Turn on the arrestor. Okay, slow down. Yeah. Okay, I think we are good here. Landing gear out. Let's go down. Nickel. Well, there's a patch here of a lot of things I see. Iron. What we need is love. Da da da. What we need is platinum. But anyway, I'm gonna do a touchdown here, and we're gonna call it an episode. I think we had a successful. The mission is successful, a success. And next episode, we will go search for the platinum. And once we have I have a lot of iron here. So once we have the platinum and the refinery is fully working on it, we can build another Truckasaurus. And that Truckasaurus will be left here. Ready to? Okay, locked. Will be left here in the planet to process a ton of wait, 9. Okay, everything is off now. To process a ton of platinum, and then we can start moving to another place, to the alien planet, for example. So the ramp is not gonna make it out. Yeah. Okay. Everything. And let me bam bam bam. Unlock. And move it a little. I can see. Till the ramp more or less gets level. Don't break the ramp, please. I think we are golden there. Lock. One of the engines, number 6, number 8. There we are. Now we can turn on the moisture evaporators and we will be getting some ice. See, just a little. Just a little each time, each time, but better than nothing. No external oxygen. Guys, we made it! Aren't you happy? We are in Mars. Mission success! Yuppie! There are no nasties here, right? Alright! So, we're gonna call it here an episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. If you want to see more content, please subscribe. And I hope to see you soon with the next episode. We're gonna be looking for platinum! Yuppie! And then, if we get a lot of platinum, we can get rich. We can sell it at the stations, have a lot of credits, and maybe with the scarce resources we can't buy any ships, but we'll see how we do. Maybe we can start building a small, I don't know how I'm gonna put it in that corner actually. We'll think about it, see how we do. Okay guys, please take care, be safe. And I will see you soon with the next one. Bye bye for now.